and welcome to Queer History 101 Part 15. A gold star lesbian is a lesbian who's never slept with a man. Gosh! However, it is a completely bogus term because your previous sexual history has absolutely no bearing on how you currently identify.
Can't eat this chicken, okay? It's homophobic. How is the chicken homophobic? Because Dad made it, and he's homophobic. How would you even know that? He doesn't even talk about that. Brian, I'm trying to tell you that I'm gay. That's a terrible way of coming out as gay.
When I was a kid, I was deathly afraid of needles, like a real phobia. So, you know, when I'm 13 and I first look at what it means to be trans, when I saw testosterone was an injection, my heart sank. And I think I kind of used it as an excuse for a long time. Like, come on, you can't be trans because you'd never be able to do the shots. I used it like a scapegoat, you know, I didn't have to think about all the other reasons it might be hard to be trans. And I know you don't have to medically transition to be trans, but it's what I told myself. You can't do the shots, so you're not trans. And this is really all just a long-winded explanation of why it feels so good to say, my name is Cass, my pronouns are they, them. And this is my voice, one day, on T.
It was the end of July when I first laid my eyes on them. I didn't really think much, didn't think twice. Suddenly I started to lose track of time. Oh, how I wish they were mine. They feel like dancing under streetlights after midnight. They sound like home. I would do anything to make sure they're never alone. Maybe one day they'll hear this and they'll know.
Alright, let's just dive right in and start talking about porn. I honestly have a lot to say, so I'm gonna do this video in two parts. I promise I'll post the second one at the same time as the first.
My favorite porn fact of all time is that homophobic men tend to be more stimulated by homosexual porn. How do I know this?
Stimulation can be measured in many ways. So the way that you can tell if someone is aroused by something is when their pupils dilate, their breathing increases, and my favorite thing, when you use a plethysmography graph.
What is that? Because who knows that word? It's an apparatus you attach to either a male's genitalia or a female's genitalia to measure blood flow to that area. Scientists were curious if homophobia was actually a real thing. Why would anybody be mad about something that has nothing to do with them? And what they found was actually wildly astonishing. When compared to men who had no feelings towards homosexuality, homophobic men actually scored way higher on the arousal chart. Participants in the study were not informed before what they were actually even going in for, so there was no way that this would have been caused by anything external. So my question for homophobic men then, when a gay man hits on you and you're pissed and you threaten to pound him, is that a threat or a promise?
No, your mom don't get it, and your dad don't get it, Uncle John don't get it. And you can't tell Grandma cause her heart can't take it, and she might not make it. They say don't dare, don't you even go there, cutting off your long hair, you do as you're told. Tell you wake up, go put on your makeup, this is just a phase, you're gonna outgrow. There's something wrong in the village, in the village. Oh, they stare in the village, in the village. Oh, there's nothing wrong with you. It's true, there's something wrong in the village, in the village. Oh.
Officially stumbled upon the LGBTQ plus survival guide. Are you asking yourself, am I a lesbian? Then the answer is probably yes.
The classic tale.
Nah, babe, sorry, I can't visit your family for Christmas. This deal is about to be locked up.
You've seen before.
What do you mean you met someone and he taught you the true meaning of Christmas?
But what happens when the jerky dumped boyfriend in any holiday TV rom-com?
Can you believe she dumped me? I mean, I was just focusing on my career and money.
Meets another.
Actually, I can. My girl dumped me because she ended up meeting a guy who turned out to be a Christmas prince in disguise.
And another.
Tell me about it. My girl fell in love with the son of Santa. Wait, did you say you liked business?
Yeah.
Do you like business?
Yes.
And money.
Find out what happens when three dudes who didn't know the true meaning of Christmas discover the true meaning of Christmas in a polyamorous love story for the ages.
All I want for Christmas is money. Money.
Poly Jolly Christmas. Coming December 25th to Lifetime.
Are you in America? Because if not, that would make sense. But if you are, do they not have the Day of Silence in schools anymore? The Day of Silence is an LGBT thing. Basically, anyone who is part of the community or an ally would take a vow of silence for the entirety of that day. Or, for a good majority of people, just for the entirety of the school day. The purpose of the Day of Silence is basically a giant silent protest to bring awareness to the fact that kids in schools or in life who are LGBT are unfairly silenced anytime they face harassment or discrimination. Something that I took very seriously to the point where I taped my own mouth shut because I had unmedicated ADHD. I literally almost started a fist fight in school over it. It was a day of protest that went on throughout the entire country every year. Do you guys not do that anymore?
Things that actually happened to me while working at a religious university, part 18.
I'm looking for this classroom.
Oh, okay. Elise, could you show him how to get there?
Well, I use she, her pronouns.
What?
Some people prefer to use different pronouns.
Oh, okay. Could you show her to the classroom then?
Yes, I can.
Hey, thanks for saying something for me. You really didn't have to.
Yeah, of course. Us girls have to stick together, right?
Yeah. So what's your name?
Well, my legal name is Samuel, but I just haven't gotten around to changing it yet.
Oh, okay. Well, do you have one in mind, if you don't mind me asking?
Well, I really like Beth.
Well, then it's nice to meet you, Beth.
Thank you.
Spending all my nights alone, waiting for you to call me. You're the only one I want for my side when I fall asleep. Tell me what I'm waiting for, tell me what I'm waiting for. Know it's hard, but we need each other. Know it's hard, but we need each other. Back and forth, take it if it's what you're asking for. With my legs up on the dashboard, the only thing in my pocket is my passport. Passport.
Mom and Dad were getting bored. Their whole lives seemed to revolve around chores. They tried new activities they thought they'd enjoy. Date nights, hobbies, and even some toys. Nothing was working. Your parents were tired. Then Mom did some research after getting inspired. Presented an idea that seemed a bit strange. They dated new people, together for a change. Humpty Dumpty Dickory Dock, your mom just needed a second man. Tonight's party time, meet your co-father Chad. He's moving right in, and it won't be bad. Skip along and count to three. We're normalizing polyamory. Mom plus Dad plus Chad is available on Amazon.
If you are non-binary, how do you communicate to somebody your sexuality?
Hi! If you're new here, hello, I've been non-binary for over a decade, and I'm here to help you be a better ally. Let's go! First of all, thank you for asking this question. It's something that not a whole lot of people talk about, and it's really interesting. From my experience, most people who identify as non-binary also either identify as bisexual or pansexual. Bisexual meaning attracted to people both within and outside of their own gender identity. And pansexual meaning hearts not parts. They're very similar, but it depends on what era you grew up in. For example, I identify as bisexual because pan wasn't a thing when I was growing up. Most MBs don't limit their attraction in a binary way, so we haven't really come up with terms for that kind of attraction level. Folks who are attracted to femme-presenting people will often call themselves sapphic. And as for mask, we really don't have a word for that yet. But the English language is always evolving, so I'm hoping we'll have some language for that very, very soon. Hopefully this helps shed light on some things.
Today I'm going to teach you what to do when that guy you've been seeing drunkenly hits on your friends in front of you with just a canvas and some paint. First, you'll consider actually dealing with the problems in your relationship, but you quickly realize that's way too exhausting. So instead, you pretend that you've forgiven him and moved on. You're a petty bitch, though, so of course you haven't. You just wait. Wait for him to get himself as blacked out as the previous time. As soon as he starts making jokes that it's the Catalina wine mixer, you know tonight is the night. I can't believe you dated a man that still uses a joke from a movie from 2008. Once he's gotten himself obliterated, you take him down to the basement. He thinks the candles that are lit down there are romantic and doesn't realize the pentagram shape that they're in. You lay this drunk adult child down in the middle of the star. Then in the blink of an eye, Satan himself cracks through the surface of the earth and ascends from hell to accept this man as payment for your eternal youth. Anyway, I actually think I might have gotten rabies over the weekend.
I'm Milo, I'm an animation student, and I need to make a short film before the end of the school year. So far, I've made a color script and some character designs, but now I need to start the storyboard and animatic. A storyboard is kind of like a rough comic that shows what each shot of a film will look like, and an animatic is a video of those panels played in time with the sound effects. I made this one last year. But diving headfirst into the storyboard is kind of hard for me, so I like to do tiny, easily changeable thumbnail sketches in my sketchbook first. At this point, I really had to think of the story I wanted to tell, and since this year was so immensely difficult, I just wanted to animate something sweet and meaningful to me. So, to confirm all of your suspicions, yes, this film will be a love story. A love story about an emotionally lost engineer and an optimistic biologist making the most of life on the most miserable ice cube humanity has ever set foot on. If you think a friend of yours needs more gay astronauts in their life, please feel free to tag them. I'd love for them to see it. Okay, bye!
In today's episode, why do gay parents raise happier kids? Not all gay people want to be parents, but those who do set the bar higher than their straight counterparts. Here's why. Our bodies are hardwired to want one thing every hour of the day, sex, and that one thing easily creates a whole fucking human being. However, gay couples can't be parents without the intention of being parents. Gay people are often satisfied with the progress of their personal goals before making this decision, so they don't place their unattained ambitions upon their children, pressuring them to live the lives they wish they had before getting pregnant. Gay parents have to go through expensive and tedious processes to have a child through donors, adoption, or surrogacy. Raising kids costs a lot of money, so these barriers pre-qualify them as parents who can financially support their kids. Queer people are often born into straight households that don't understand them, but they eventually know the joy of being able to live as they are, and that's ingrained in every piece of their parenting. Kids raised by gay parents are less likely to live with the pressure to be who they aren't. So it's no wonder why Christian conservatives have battled same-sex parenting for decades, because they know it's better. They don't want people to realize what happens when you're actually ready to be a parent, because it will expose their own bad parenting, which has led to childhood abuse, broken foster systems, and Ben Shapiro.
Important announcement. Please pay attention. This is a bean and this is a bean. They are both girls and they're in love. Lesbian.
Alright, this one's for my fellow bisexuals. Here are 5 incredible bisexual music artists that you should be looking up to.
And hit plus if you're already doing that with any of them.
Gaga, Jason Mraz, Halsey, Rosie Armstrong, and Dave.
I just came here to the party for the
a child. No. Truck.
I'm not trying to make a friend.
Now what the hell?
Eugene?
Yeah?
Eugene?
What is it, Earl? What the hell is this in my pantry?
In the pantry? I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know?
I mean I don't know, Earl.
Well, I don't know either. Let's get a closer look at you.
Well, what does it look like?
Well, it looks like...
Like a what?
Well, I'll tell you, it looks like a pansexual.
What is that?
Well, I don't know what the hell it is.
Well, what's it doing?
What? What the hell do you think you're doing to that pan... No, get the hell...
You, me, She by Harry Styles, the backseat of a car, 9:30 p.m. I'll see you there.
What's up, guys? This one's going out to Matthew Carter. He wanted the trans flag logo on here, and his colors he chose was baby blue, some pink, and some white. So let's do it. It's gonna be a pretty cool one. Here we go.
Hi, I just wanted to let you know that in this household, we do not support transphobia, homophobia. What's another phobia? We don't like spiders either. Spiders are ugly.